It's great to see.
And an era when you played the Rod Langway, the Craig Lachlan trade, that was one of the parts that sort of put the team on the next level. But what was that like to experience it as a core, as a team, Larry Murphy's, Bobby Carpenter, some of the players who were here and those playoff appearances started to come in rapid succession?
Well, we could see that our team was getting better. We were acquiring some good young talent. You mentioned the guys that we had, Ryan Walter, you know, then we had Bobby Carpenter, and I was drafted in there, and we had Scott Stevens, and then the trade happened with where we traded two very good hockey players away in Ryan Walter and Rick Green, who they went on to win a Stanley Cup with Montreal, but we got four back in return, and those guys were able to just give us the numbers and the quality that we needed to get over that hump, and you look at that, and those are big decisions that were made back then, but ones that were necessary for our franchise in order to kind of move into that next phase and become a successful franchise and be a perennial contender, but also a perennial playoff team, and you have to get in the playoffs to do anything, and we were able to turn the corner and do that.
And among the challenges, though, year after year, you would run into a New York Islanders team. Of all days for you to be here, Mike, we have the New York Islanders in town today. They were a challenge. They were one that it was tough to get by in the 80s.
Well, it was, and those were the 10 times that we started. We weren't a very good hockey team, but became a good hockey team, but it was also when the Islanders were winning four consecutive Stanley Cups, so they were tough teams to play against. Philly was finishing usually in the top five at that time. The Rangers had a strong team. And so when you come in and you see a team like the Islanders, who have made a great turnaround in the last couple of years, and they've got a good hockey team. So it's never, or should I say, it's always easy rooting against the Islanders. So I know who I'm rooting for tonight, but looking at the shots on goal, I think the Caps are going to have to get a few more than four shots on goal to make this a good hockey game.
But I imagine for you too, Mike, and real quick here, as we're with Mike Gardner during the first intermission, you
off the fucking road,
playing the New York Islanders in a divisional race here. This is Patrick Division-esque. None of this Southeast Division. This must bring back some memories as well as far as rivalries in the history.
Yeah, and the rivalries go deep, and you can call it whatever divisions you want, whether it's the Metropolitan Division or the old Patrick Division, but these are long rivalries that both Philly, Washington, the Rangers, and the New York Islanders have had, and those will remain.
Final thing with you, Mike, what do you like about this team? Nicky Backstrom, now the NHL's leading goal scorer, leading point getter. Alex Ovechkin, leading goal scorer. A lot of firepower, but a lot of structure as well this year with head coach Barry Trotz.
And that's the key thing, I think, that everybody has been saying over the last number of years. They've had the firepower offensively, and now there seems to be a structure in place that everybody's buying into. And I think that there's only better things that can happen when the team is still offensively explosive, still has the top scorer and the top point getter in the league, but at the same time is able to play a more structured defensive type game when necessary, and that's a winning combination.
Well, we wish you all the best, Mike. Enjoy the rest of the afternoon here and your visit here in Washington, D.C. Thank you, Mike Gardner.
Thanks, Ben.
There he is, Mike Gardner, Hockey Hall of Fame member, and again, one of four Capitals to have his jersey retired here at Verizon Center. Capitals and Islanders tied at one, first intermission. Johnny Kent standing by, play-by-play of the second period up next on the Capitals Radio Network.
Your special starts on Epics.
Yeah, it's every day what we do and how we come.
Team Epics presents Roads, the NHL Stadium Series. Experience the journey on and off the ice with the Los Angeles Kings and the San Jose Sharks as they prepare to face off outside.
It'll be 70,000 people.
This should be quite an atmosphere. Epics presents Roads, the NHL Stadium Series. Brought to you by Coors Light, a four-part Epics original series. New episode Tuesdays, 10, 9 central. Watch free, watch live on Epics.com and NHL.com.
For more than 40 years, big beer corporations have dominated the market with their idea of light beer. We believe it's time for something different. That's why we started brewing Yingling Light Lager, a lower-calorie beer with true lager taste. 99 calories, 100% lager, with a rich amber color unlike any other light beer. It's light beer that makes a statement. Next time you order a light beer, make a statement of your own. With Yingling Light Lager, rethink your light beer. D.G. Yingling, Sun, Pottsville, Pennsylvania. Please enjoy responsibly.
When you save money and join the 97% of people who are satisfied with GEICO, it's hard not to give yourself a big thumbs up. But why do we humans use the thumb to express approval? Here, I extend my stubbiest of digits in your honor. Some human behaviors don't make sense. And some do, like switching your car insurance to GEICO, which people have been doing for over 75 years. And that's worthy of a big thumbs up. Perhaps two.
GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
NHL ticket exchange gives fans
only official ticket exchange of the NHL, where every Capitals ticket is verified by Ticketmaster. This is how the NHL does it. You don't just get somebody's old ticket, but a new one reissued just for you. Don't get burned by fake tickets. Buy or sell at NHL.com/ticket exchange. NHL Ticket Exchange is the trademark of the National Hockey League.